Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Tech Guru. Please click on the like, share and subscribe button.
Can we add more sprites in Scratch?
Yes, we can add as many sprites as we want and we can also move them. And do you know the interesting part? We can change the complete look of our story by changing the backdrops.
Backdrops? How can we change it? Please tell me.
Oh yes, sure. I will tell you.
Today I am going to tell you how can you change the backdrop and how can you add new sprites. If you want to change the backdrop, go to this button. It is used to add new backdrops. Click on it. There are four options. First one is choose a backdrop. Now it is showing already available backdrops. You can choose any backdrop from here depending on the theme. For example, I take this one. Just click on it. See? The second option is paint. If you want to create your backdrop, you can create your own backdrop like this. I choose this option. I draw a square. Now I draw a circle. You can change its color. You can use this for random drawings and anything like this. Now come back to code. So right now we are having three backdrops. I click on this button. This is the surprise. It means it will automatically give some backdrop. Look, every time I click, it gives a different backdrop. And the last one is upload backdrop. You can click on this. If you have a drawing that is already saved in your computer, you can choose that drawing as a backdrop. For example, I go to a location and I choose a drawing. Look, I have added the backdrop. This is my sprite and this is the backdrop. So friends, in this way, you can change the complete look of your story. So friends, if you want to see all the backdrops that we have added just now, simply click here. Now, backdrop option is there. Click on it. And you can remove the backdrops that you don't want. Look, I click on it. So I'm going to keep this one only. Alright, I come back to my coding part. Now, as you can see, this backdrop is underwater. So this sprite doesn't suit here. So I want to remove it and add a new sprite. So first of all, I remove this sprite. Just click on it from here and you will get this delete button. And it is deleted. Now I go to this sprite button. There are also four options. Choose a sprite. You can choose your sprite like this. As my backdrop is underwater, I can choose this sprite. Now, this second option is about paint. You can create your own sprite by using the different options available here. You can draw like this. The sprite would be added. Right? If you don't want to use that sprite, simply delete it. The third option is surprise. It will automatically give you a sprite. This one. And the last option is upload. If you have any picture that you have created in any other software or you have downloaded from the net, you can upload that picture as a sprite here. For example, I choose this one. Look, the sprite has been added. So friends, right now as per my backdrop, now I am going to create a story. So I don't need these two sprites as per my backdrop. I need this diver only. Now let's change its look. I double click on it so that it is selected. Now I can change its properties. So I go to this option. The first one is size. By default it is 100. If I want to reduce the size, then type a number smaller than 100. See, if you want to increase its size, then type a number greater than 100. So I am typing 200 now. So as per my scene, I am changing its value to 150. Now that's perfect. Let's change its direction also. The next option is direction 90 degree. I want it to be like this. Yes, I keep it here. I think 150 is greater. I choose it 120. Yeah, that's perfect. Now friends, just look here, the X and Y. Basically, this complete screen is divided into X and Y coordinates. It is something like that. This is the X axis and this is the Y axis. So this particular point is basically 0, 0. X is also 0 and Y is also 0 here. Right now, the value minus 115 indicates this is the negative part. Here the values are negative for X and here the values are positive. In simple way, you can remember this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. And this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. In the same way, for Y it is 1, 2, 3, 4 positive numbers, and here it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. So as you work on it, you will automatically understand these numberings. For example, I show you one thing. If I bring my sprite here, now X and Y, both the values are 0. It means that is the exact center of my stage. If I want to bring my sprite little bit right side, I can simply change the X axis. I type 50. Look, it has changed its direction. Now if I want to move it upward, no need to change X, we will simply change Y because this is the Y axis. I change it to 50. Look, alright, so right now I am changing its position to this. Now let's add one more sprite. I add this jellyfish. Oh, it looks bigger, so let's reduce its size. I change it to 50. Now perfect. Let's add more sprites. Let's change its color. I choose color, this bucket, and fill it. Now come back to the coding part. Now friends, it's about the look. One more thing, this jellyfish. I double click on it to select it. Go to costumes and see, there are four costumes are available for this jellyfish. You can choose whatever style you want. I am choosing this one, the angry jellyfish. Now come back to the coding part. This is the base. We have changed the backdrop, we have added some sprites, and we have changed its costume. Now let's add some animation to it. Let's move our sprites. So friends, when we have more than one sprites, we have to code separately for each sprite. For example, just look at this carefully. This is diver. It means whatever code I write, it will be about this diver. Now if I click on jellyfish, this code area is for jellyfish. If I click on fish, now this code area is for fish. So for separate sprites, we have separate code areas. If you want to give coding for this diver, first of all, select it. Now consider you want to move the diver. So what I can do, I go to motion and the first one is move 10 steps. I simply drag it and put here. Alright, now I told you in my first video, whenever you add any code, you have to click on this green flag to run the code. But look, it's not working. Why? Because in Sprite, whenever we want to run any code, we have to give an event. Event, it means we go to the events block here. From events block, the first one is when flag clicked. I drag it and put it here. Now friends, if you see carefully, This when flag click block, it looks like a hat. So it is called a hat block. And we cannot put any block over this block. This should be the first block whenever we write the code. And if you see this move block, it is having a notch at the top and a bump at the bottom. This is called stack block. It means we can put these types of blocks one after another. Alright, so whenever we have to write any code, we have to give an event, and that event is given by when flag clicked block. This is the first block. Then I add this code, move 10 steps. Now let's click on the flag and see. I click on this button to show the output on a bigger screen. Now I click on flag. Just see, friends, my diver is moving 10 steps. Right? Now I bring it back here. Now consider, at the same time I want to give code for this fish also. So click on fish. It is selected now. This is the coding area for fish. So now we know, first of all, we have to choose this one, when flag click. Now I want to move my fish further. So I go to motion. I choose move 10 steps. Instead of moving 10 steps, you can give 5 steps, 10 steps, whatever you want. I am giving 5 steps. Now let's see the output. Look, now fish is moving 5 steps and the diver is moving 10 steps. Now bring them back. Now I want to add some coding for jellyfish also. I click on it. First of all, when flag clicked, I go to motion. Now instead of moving 10 steps, now I am choosing this one, go to random position. It means the jellyfish will be moved here and there randomly. Let's see the output. Look, it is changing its position every time. Now let's add one more code for this jellyfish, because we know this jellyfish is having more than one costume. Let's go to the code, select the jellyfish, go to the looks, because costume comes under looks. So I go to looks part, and there is a code, next costume. I simply add it. Now let's see the magic. See, every time I click on the flag, the jellyfish is randomly going to a new position and changing its costume also. Now I go back to diver. I want to remove this move 10 steps code. I simply drag it back, go to motion, and I choose go to random position for diver also. Now let's see. The scene is very interesting now. Both jellyfish and diver are going to the random position, but the fish is going in a straight line. So friends, in this way you can add multiple sprites, you can change the backdrop, and you can create your own story. So that's it for today's session. Thank you for watching. Keep learning. Bye bye.